This is a 3D printed prototype of a bottle that I designed. It's an SLA part, it's 1 millimeter thick, and this is what you get from a major North American service bureau. It's translucent at best. I'm going to show you how to make it transparent so that you can read through it. Don't forget to follow me on social media, on Twitter, at Botzen Design, and now on Instagram, at Botzen Design. I always post stuff there long before it gets to YouTube here. My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up, and then you hit the bell. Hit the bell again so you get the little parentheses around it. That way you'll be notified every time I have a new video. Don't forget to check out the design and making merch just below the video on the shelf. T-shirts, hoodies, stickers, leggings, and phone cases. So when the FedEx guy or the UPS guy drops this off, I often only have a little bit of time. So normally I'm making FDM prints like this and I'm showing them to my clients, but sometimes they want to actually see what a clear bottle looks like because they're going to blow mold this thing and they want to see what a clear bottle that I designed looks like before they spend all their money. So I don't have a lot of time sometimes, literally a couple hours often, and I got to make this part look better. It looks like shit. You know, it's got scratch marks all over it. I don't know how this passes quality control at Stratasys. I mean, come on. This is terrible. So the best I can do sometimes is just clear coat the part with a little bit of duplicolor clear in a can, you know, and get something sort of halfway decent so I can take it to my clients so they don't fall on the floor and go, what is this, Eric? This is what you get when it dries. It's okay. You can kind of see through it. It looks halfway decent. It's representational of a clear bottle. It's average. I'm going to show you how you can make it so it's transparent and you can actually see through it. In this video, we're going to cover the same process with two different substrates of materials. This first material in this square bottle, where I'm sanding the mark out of it, and this is how it came, is using a substrate called WaterShed, using an SLS process to make the bottle. The second bottle that we're going to do this process to uses a SDSL process using a material called WaterClear, and it gives us different results. Once I've sanded the scratch out of the inside of the bottle the best I can, I'm going to start wet sanding the build marks out of this bottle, and I'm going to start with a 220 grit sandpaper. We're going to first wet sand this bottle to 320 grit, and here I got a couple sample bottles. After 320, we're going to go to the next step. We're going to go to 400. We're going to wet sand that, and they're going to have a halfway decent finish. Now, this was kind of super quick turnaround. I didn't have a lot of time, a little bit of a test using some new materials and stuff. So they don't have the greatest finish on the outside and only average finish on the inside. And the only reason I would be sanding these things on the inside is if we're going to clear coat on the inside as well. Otherwise, I would leave that alone and not scratch it up, because that's really not going to help my cause. So this is what the part looks like. 400 grit, wet sanded on the outside and cleaned up on the inside. Yeah, that's right. Wear the appropriate safety gear. I'm using a two-part automotive refinish clear coat here. The mixture is 4 parts to 1. It is urethane. It smells. It can get in your eyes, cause eye irritation. Wear the appropriate safety gear. All right, we'll mix this stuff up and we're gonna spray it out onto those bottles. But before we spray it out, we're gonna pour some on the inside and we're gonna coat this bottle. So coating it on the bottle is going to smooth out the inside, basically. So you can't see very much here because it's coated on the inside and the outside, obviously, as a 400 grit finish. The proof will be in the pudding, of course, when we spray the outside here. So it doesn't look like very much at the moment, but I pour that stuff in and then pour the rest of the stuff into the gun, and we're going to coat the outside. I'm using some cardboard tubes here just so I can hold the bottle without getting urethane all over my hands. Just using an HVLP gun here, doing a couple, two light coats on this bottle. And you can see as that clear goes on, the part starts to become pretty transparent. It doesn't look really great right now when you spray it out. The clear has to flow out a little bit, and that's just the first coat. Alrighty, so let's compare the two. That's a pretty dramatic improvement. You can clearly see through the bottle. So that looks clear to me. And now I'm dealing with the clear coat that's on the inside of this bottle. And what I'm doing here is I'm trying to get it to drip down nice and even everywhere on the inside of the bottle. So this takes a little bit of effort, a little bit of patience, a little bit of time, so that we don't get any runs or sags on the inside of the clear coat. Not the normal way you apply clear coat onto a product, but in this case, takes a little work. This is the part after it's been sprayed. It's not dry yet. It still has a little bit of texture, but here it is, all dry. And you can clearly see through it. You can even see some of the little support materials on the inside. This is another project here where there's about 16 of these bottles. Yeah, this is a couple grand worth of parts right here, boys and girls. I'm going to take this one and do something a little bit nicer than we did on the first one. And I want to kind of show you the differences of spending some extra time. Now this bottle right here has been clear coated on the outside. So finished to 400 grit on the outside. For whatever reason, when Stratasys made these bottles, since they cost a whole bunch of money and they were making a whole bunch of them, I kind of bitched about the other ones not being such great quality. They are printed and they're a lot nicer. I'm not sure what they changed in their process, but those bottles that they sent me where I spent a whole bunch of money on, they really took their time. There were no scratches on the inside of those like there were on the other ones, and they came out really nice. So that one has been clear coated on the outside after the wet sanding, and I'm going to pour some clear on the inside. And this bottle turns out a lot nicer than the other ones, just because, I don't know, maybe different process somehow there or whatever, but sort of the luck of the draw, I guess. I'm not really sure. But I do put in a fair amount of clear on the inside here, and you can see me rolling it on all the surfaces on the inside to make sure that they are coated very nice. And of course I can touch the outside of the bottle here because that's already been clear coated. And I'm taking my time, making sure there's no air bubbles or anything. And then here, I'm rolling the clear coat into the neck area, making sure that I get everything coated really nice, and so we don't have any issues. So once I'm happy with the inside and it's clear coated really nice, I'm going to dump out the excess clear coat back into the container. And we'll put the cardboard tube on it here. Now, luckily, I have two of these bottles, so we can compare directly one to the other. This one, the quality is much, much better. You can see it's bordering on an actual plastic blow-molded part. Looks pretty nice. Here's a quick flyby of the part drying. Pretty happy with that. Now check out the part on the left here. There's a little hazing at the top. It came that way from the factory. Don't know what that is. I couldn't get it out. But this part here is the part that we just clear coated on the inside. It looks very, very nice when you compare that to the one with no clear on the inside. And then the one on the far left is the way it's going to come from the factory clear. I mean, translucent. This is a huge improvement. So you can see, almost kind of make out the basics of my business card where it's just clear coat on the outside, and with the clear on the inside and the outside, you can read the text of my business card. Super happy with that part. Let's add a little bit of water because ultimately these bottles hold material and my client wants to see what they look like with liquid on the inside of them. And so they want to see that. And you can see the one on the left, clear coat only on the outside. The one on the right there, clear coat inside and out. A little bit better simulation of what an actual blow molded bottle would look like. So if you or your company have bottles that need to be designed, I can take care of that from design to production data and the prototypes as well. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. You can do that by clicking on the icon in the bottom right of the video or below the video. Give it a thumbs up and follow the channel there as well. Hey, and don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook sometimes, Twitter usually, and now Instagram. Rock on. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.